Heretics defends against Alma Unigu. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. This one brought to you by Shanghai Media Group. Look out for the power in the hands of Stan Fairchex in these 4 ounce gloves. There is no margin for error. Superb Thai technique on Alma Unigu.
And the bright lights do not seem to get into Alma Unigu. She seems very calm, very relaxed, excited to be in there.
And Alma's competed in China here before. She knows what it's about, a two-time world champion. Stan Fairchex's first time in China. Has won on the road before, of course. She won in Singapore against Janet Tsai. Outside leg kick from Unigu. The Australian in the pink trunks. The Thai in the black and white. High kick to a right hand there from Stan Fairchex.
See a very long high guard from Unigu. Let's see how she uses that. Her body's almost curled away so she can avoid those body kicks.
In her one Super Series career so far, Stan Fairchex has not competed against anyone as well-credentialed as Alma Unigu.
She's just 18, Michael. She's so young. She's got so much road ahead of her.
So nice too, Stan Fairchex, only 21 years old.
Go!
Jab there from Alma. Scott Moss giving her instructions in her corner. Prem Fairchex in the corner of Stan. Patient start from both these women. Front kick from Alma. Counter right roundhouse kick there from the champion, Stan Fairchex.
Beautiful evasion there, the push kick to land a body kick by Stan Fairchex.
Jing two and a roundhouse kick. Tucks it on the left arm of Alma Unigu.
Alma's got to be a little bit more aggressive. She can't let Stamp get off like this.
Some Australians in the audience here tonight at the Battle Show Arena. The charts go up. Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. Oi, oi, oi.
Go.
High guards from both of these ladies. Very long legs on Alma Unigu. From Queensland, Australia, up north. Nice threading knee there from Stamp Fairchex. Referee Atsushi Onari calls for it.
Alma does have about a 6 centimeter height advantage. And it looks like it's all in her legs.
Now you are allowed to grapple to clinch under these Muay Thai rules, but while in the clinch, you've got to stay busy. Three judges ringside are scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winner of the round 10 points, the less dominant boxer gets 9 points. So wherever you're watching in 140 countries plus around the world, get out your notepad and pen. Give someone 10, give someone 9 after one round. It's our main event of One Championship Legend Request live from Shanghai, China.
Good first round by both these women. That was that straight right hand. That was the best punch of the round, slicing right through the guard of Unigu. And then she lands that body kick. That seems to be her game plan for this one. She wants to throw the hands, 2-3 punch combinations, and then finish with a kick. That's usually Unica's MMO. She likes to throw the body kick. She likes to throw the hands, finish with the kicks. But Stan Fairchex is starting to do that. We haven't even seen Stan enter the clinch yet. We haven't seen her work and start working the dumps. She's just playing Alma Unica's game.
Okay, out.
All smiles in the corner of 18-year-old phenom Alma Unigu, a two-time world champion, against another two-time world champion in Stan Fairchex. Sparkling, glittering crowd. 7 months ago, the Baoshan Arena in the world's biggest city, Shanghai. Orthodox stances on both of these incredible athletes. Over 130 martial arts world champions on the One Championship roster. You're seeing two of them in the ring right now. Fairchex cracks away to the upper up ribs. Looking for a sweet takedown there was Alma Unigu.
Go!
Unigu's heritage from Albania. Stan Fairchex, who grew up in rural Thailand. A real rags to riches story. Nice jab to them from Unigu.
Like the jab of Unigu. It's really finding a home on the chin of
Kick to the outside lead thigh from Stan Fairchex. front kick to the midsection from Yunuke. Right hand lead to an outside leg kick, tenderizing that quadriceps area is the champion, Fairjax. Jab two, kangaroo from the Australian. They clinch up center of the ring. Knee there, threaded in nicely from Yunuke. And referee Onari calls break.
Go!
Yunuku's handling herself very well inside that clinch. She's got her body positioned down. She's avoiding all the dumps and stamps.
Nicely done from Oma Yunuke.
That's the second time the stamp's been put down on her butt by catching that leg kick and that throwing those hands.
Checks the inside leg kick, Yunuke. Look how tight and high the guard is on Oma Yunuke. Her corner telling her, keep the gloves up. Stamp looks for the counter right hand, throws a roundhouse kick off the back leg. 1:10 remains, second round of five, main event here tonight. Muay Thai world title on the line. Roundhouse kick to the waist there from the champion, Stamp Fairtex.
At least in the first two rounds, we're not seeing a lot of counter striking. We're seeing whoever goes first, they're the one that's scoring.
You know that Stamp and the entire crew at Team Fairtex have studied a lot of footage of Oma Yunuke. Tremendous respect shown for the talent, the technique, the strategy of Yunuke and her coach Scott Moss. Usually we do see Stamp open up very heavy on her opponents, not so tonight, a more cerebral contest. She can spot a chink in the Australian's armor. Jab from Yunuke, no right hand for company. Gets off the ropes to Fairtex.
Good parry there from Stamp Fairtex.
Counter right hand from Fairtex goes to the outside thigh. Clinch now from Yunuke, brings a knee up to the right rib cage. Elbow from Stamp Fairtex. Uppercut elbow from Fairtex.
Go.
Second round almost in the books here. We're going into the third. Wherever you're watching, folks, 140 countries around the world. Hope you're enjoying it. Big hello to all of our fans in Thailand. Watch on Thai TV, channel 32. Who do you score it for so far, folks? Do you have it, Stamp Fairtex? Do you have it for Oma Yunuke?
I'm going to throw the question back at you. How do you have it?
Mitch, I can't separate them after two rounds, but I will say this. The judges at the end of five, no matter how close this is, in one super series, there are no draws. There's no extension round. We must have a decision.
Now, those are two very close rounds. I mean, we're seeing nobody's really taking advantage. Nobody's scoring really clean shots. The only clean shot that was landed was in the first. That second round was very close. Oma Yunuke has put down on basically like a trip takedown with the right hand landed. So nobody's scoring effectively. It's very close these first two rounds.
Go!
It's a marvelous sight here in Shanghai, China, the Baoshan Arena for one championship legendary quest's main event. And now I get the feeling we may see the aggressive meter rise. We may see the mercury, the intensity rise. Third round of five.
Go!
We have to see them turn it up right now. Nice jab landed by Yunuke. Let's see if she can put together some jabs.
Counter right hand from Yunuke. Trying to backstab into the corner. Cross arm across the face there from Stamp Fairtex.
That little turn that she's doing right there inside the clinch is really controlling Stamp very well. She's not going face to face. She's not going chest to chest with Stamp Fairtex. She's angling her body, and Stamp's not able to turn and dump her.
On the inside, Oma Yunuke looking confident. Good knee to the breadbasket there from Stamp Fairtex. Oma negates them, glances over to her corner. Scott Moss giving instructions. Dances back to centering the Australian. Sticks a jab in the face. There's a right hand. Nicely done from Yunuke. Jab from Yunuke. No right hand on that occasion. Stamp's got to pick up the pace here. There's a right hand from Fairtex.
That jab's working for Yunuke. Like see her following up with the kicks. That's what she's usually doing. Ventura, she's just falling into the hands.
Look up at the big screen to see how much time's remaining. Just past the halfway point of this third of five. Outside leg kick from the Australian. Jab Yunuke, right cross counter there from Stamp Fairtex.
You called Yunuke a phenom, and she's got experience well beyond her years. A phenom might be a phenom at this description of this young lady.
18 years old, two-time world champion. And it's another two-time world champion. Oh, what's the headbutt of Stan Fairtex? How about that?
That's two beautiful right hands landed by Fairtex there. You start to see the snarl develop on the face of Fairtex. She's starting to throw heat behind those punches.
Thought about the jab, and did Fairtex. Unoku stepped up the jab. Ratchet armbands around the biceps of Unoku. Spinning back elbow from the Aussie. Knees in succession from the tie. And referee Ono re-breaks them.
Go! She set that up. She faked the push. Spinning that elbow.
Crossing elbow from Unoku. Stamp turns her around nicely. Knee from Unoku. Puts on the knee guard to Stamp Fairtex. Good defense. Final 10 seconds. Been some fantastic periods, especially for Alma Unoku in this round.
Go!
Skips forward the Australian. Two more rounds to go. I would hate to be a judge on this one, Mitch, but I thought that was a very good round for Alma Unoku.
Yeah, I feel the same way. She was able to land that right hand effectively. She was the one pushing forward. She controlled center ring. And there's a nice right hand landed by, but it's her head movement. She's always slightly off angle. She's doing a good job of controlling that center ring, and especially inside the clinch. I'm surprised at how well she's doing by angling her body inside the clinch, so Stamp's not getting any clean techniques, and she's not utilizing that redirect dump that she's done so well in the past.
An in swell being applied below the right eye of Stamp Fairtex. Some damage from the hands of Alma Unoku. Relaxed calm in the corner of Unoku. She's been enjoying herself around Shanghai all week. Says she wants to reward herself after this contest by taking a trip to Disneyland. Why not? Fourth round of five, the penultimate round of action for the One Super Series Women's Adamant Muay Thai World Championship, held by the lady in black and white, Stan Fairtex of Thailand. Double right hands from Fairtex.
Nice right hand landed again by Unoku.
Fairtex has also made no secret she'd like to become a three-sport world champion. She'd like to vie for a mixed martial arts world championship somewhere down the line. Wouldn't that be amazing?
Nice.
Meanwhile, though,
right,
she's got her hands very full with Alma Unoku tonight.
She's going to have to lean on that world championship experience right now. She's going to have to turn it up.
Unoku goes for the lead leg. Come to there from Fairtex. Roundhouse kick and a clipping right. There's a stinging lead hand from Stan Fairtex. Goes down to the bread basket. Fake from Alma. Rocks the head back with a jab. Overhand right. Round kick from Stan. Scott Moss saying, staying tight with Stan Fairtex. Keep him close. Work the elbows. Work the hands. Alma comes over the top with the right elbow.
By Unoku to keep Stamp inside that corner. Stamp's got to circle out. She can't allow Unoku to pressure up against that corner and keep her there.
Counter right hand from Stamp Fairtex. Outside leg kick, counter right again from Fairtex. Fairtex got to get off the ropes here. They are throwing single shots. I'd like to see some more combinations, particularly from Stan Fairtex. When we've seen her get on song with that right hand in succession, she could be devastating.
Looks like Stamp's fighting with just a pure emotion right now. She's kind of abandoned a lot of her techniques. She's just swinging at the fences.
Trying to keep her against the ropes and maybe move her to one of the corners. Low check from Stamp and a right hand. Still though, Alma Unoku controlling center ring. Stamp content to stay on the outside. Had a chance to move forward then. Trips off to her right counterclockwise. Now goes to her left into the power side of Unoku.
Stamp's starting to land though. She's trying to find some success with those hands.
4 for 5. They clinch up a chart for the knees. And referee, oh no, he breaks them. very tight contest between two world champions. Four world championship belts between them.
Good evasion there from the right hand by Unihu. Nice jab by Stamp.
The corner of Alma, Unihu saying, go Alma, she's tired, take a look. One more round to go. Is Stamp Fairtex tiring? Is the champ showing fatigue?
She's got her hands on the ropes. She looks a little bit fatigued. We're usually used to seeing Stamp dance around, showboating. But Alma Unihu is right there with her. We could be two rounds apiece, Michael Schiavello.
Once again, there can be no draws in one Super Series. No extension rounds. We must have a winner.
Good. She threw the jab, avoided the retaliation from Stamp, and then landed another jab. Alma is quietly landing these shots on Stamp, and she's got her frustrated.
Prem Fairtex and the team in the corner of Stamp. Scott Moss and the team in the corner of the Australian Alma Unihu. Fifth and final round inside the sold-out Baoshan Arena in Shanghai, China. It has been a marvelous show. 3 minutes remains.
I gotta say, Michael, I'm kind of surprised. I'm a little bit shocked to see Unihu hanging there with Stamp Fairtex.
I'm not at all, Mitch. As I said, two-time world champion on paper. She presents it. The biggest set of credentials that Stamp has faced in her career, yet it's proving that here tonight in the ring.
I underestimated her. I took her age into consideration. I thought Stamp would run away with this, but Unihu is right there. Look at her control in the center ring, pushing forward. As in Stamp on the back foot. How often have we seen Stamp on the back foot?
And Stamp needs to do her name. She needs to stamp her authority, stamp her place. Stamp again with Unihu. Unihu backs her up again into the corner. Not where Stamp Fairtex wants to be.
Go!
If Unihu, Alma Unihu gets the win tonight, at 18 years old, she'll be the youngest world champion in one history. Younger than Christian Lee, younger than Angela Lee. Such an historical context for this one. And this is Stamp Fairtex's first ever title defense of her Muay Thai crown.
Stamp's got to circle out. Now she's back into center cage, or center ring. She's got to push forward. She's got a minute and a half here, 100 seconds to do work.
Australia has never had a one Super Series world champion. Thailand has had a number of them. They've been the dominant country in one Super Series. In kickboxing and Muay Thai. 80 seconds now remains.
Nice overhand right landed by Unihu.
Here's Scott Moss saying, you're in it to win it. Let's go, Alma Unihu.
Go!
Stamp Fairtex continually on the outside. Not coming off those ropes. Now she does with a flurry, but then she drifts backwards.
That right hand landed there to end that combination. That was a three-piece combination, and it finished with a nice little side of prize.
Mitch, you know what we're also not seeing from Stamp are the roundhouse kicks. It's all boxing from Stamp Fairtex. Where are the round kicks to the legs? Where's the round kick we know she has to the head? It's just not there from the champion.
It's all hands. You gotta wonder, is something wrong with her legs? Is something wrong with her foot?
It's not the Stamp Fairtex we've come to know. Is there an issue with Stamp, or is Alma Unihu simply, methodically picking her apart?
Stamp's landing in this round right here. So, I mean, this is a very close matchup right now. It could have been 2-2, and Stamp is finding a lot of success.
Oh, that's from Stamp Fairtex! And she'll let it take it.
Unihu's not putting the pedal to the metal here. She's kind of giving Stamp a little bit of a break here.
Stamp has scored some very good points in the dying stages. It's going to go down to judges. It's going to be razor close. Who takes the crown? Who takes the strap? Stamp Fairtex or Alma Unihu? Too close to call, Dragon. Too close.
Wow, what an intense battle. We're both kind of holding our breath here, waiting for the judge's decision. Yunuku looked tremendous in her debut. And it was for a world title, another world title here at One Super Series. The bright lights did not faze her at all. She put on a tremendous performance. Is she that good, or was something off her stamp, Michael?
A lot of questions about to be answered. That's what Stamps does so well when she catches the leg, counters with those quick succession right hands. We saw her do it amazingly against Jenna Todd. Tonight, though, let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have Chief Editor of Great Sports Media, Ms. Li Pei Hong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, and still one women's atomweight Muay Thai world champion, Steph Fairtex.
It was an amazing contest. The rain of gold over the ring in Shanghai, and the rain of gold continues for Stan Fairtex. Fight!
Steve, the Lees only have one speed, and that is full tilt boogie. Can she control herself, slow it down? Because this is a five-round battle here tonight, so there's a long time to be in there. She looks composed, looks relaxed.
That straight-up style that Angela has when they're standing up exaggerates the size advantage that she has over Yamaguchi.
That was a nice little leg kick. She landed right there. She faked the right, came in with the left. Nice little tap on the inside of the leg and then lands a couple of the strikes. You can see the height difference between these two. So there's definitely going to be a reach there for Angela. How is she going to utilize that?
Will Yamaguchi force Lee to show us what she has in her fists? Hasn't had the opportunity, hasn't needed to demonstrate her punching power yet. We can't say she doesn't have it. She just hasn't shown it to us. 1 minute down. This is a five-round contest, 5 minutes away.
Angela Lee has finished all of her opponents in double fast time, and Yamaguchi has never been finished. So somebody's always about to go.
Low center of gravity Yamaguchi has. You can see she's strong.
Inside in the clinch. And you gotta think once this fight gets to the ground, that, you know, innovative ground game of Angela Lee is gonna show dominance. But Yamaguchi is so technically sound on the ground. She's never been finished.
She takes a good left hook to the head there.
In 24 fights, she's never been finished, so it's going to be really hard. She's really tough, got that samurai spirit.
Will Angela Lee be the first person to finish her? Five rounds, will it go that far? We're 2 minutes into this contest. 12,000 fans in Singapore looking at a bit of history. Significant moment in ONE Championship history, this.
Nice little knee landed in there. Head kick, caught the kick, but it did connect halfway.
She wasn't quite as crisp with that kick as she needed to be.
Angela Lee jumps guard and reverses into mount. That was beautiful.
Fans are going nuts here in Singapore.
They knew exactly what they saw there. Possible guillotine here. She's got the arm under the neck, but see how she keeps her head real high? She's got to keep that up there. It's a real dangerous position to be in.
Showed good strength to get back on her feet, but straight into the guillotine. But as you say, she's up nice and high. That prevents the leverage, the torque Angela needs to really use this and convert it into a finishing move. Yamaguchi has the presence of mind to dig in a right hand to the body and work something of her own.
She's in a dangerous position right here. She's got the arm outside. You know, so it's very deep right here. She's got to do the right thing. She's got to put her head down. This is a bad position. She's got the body triangle. This is deep, Steve.
Her body triangles just stopping her from moving.
Now she's a little bit high, she's a little bit twisted. She might not have it, but May's tough. She's never been finished, but she's cranking on it.
Look out, Olivia Cost is so close. He's primed, he's ready to call it over. But that tap hasn't come.
You can see the side of her neck right there is exposed, so it's more of a neck crank. She's more of cranking on the neck this way.
This is a tiring move to hold for too long, though, Mitch, isn't it?
Yeah, you have to. That's experience. You have to know when to let go and when to just not gas out your arms. There is another 21 minutes left in this fight, so it's very, very important that she doesn't, you know, but she might really believe in this. She's got this in there.
1 minute left in this round, though. It's a long time. Looks like she's just slipping out of it, does it? It's a tough one.
You could have it's really tough to tell what May's feeling, but she's looking like she's trying to pull her head out.
The strain on Angela's face.
Which is not really the best way to go. Angela looks like she's really putting a lot into it. You know, she's trying to adjust. Good adjustment there by May, how she just stepped over that leg. Now she's out of the danger zone.
Digging in the punches to the side of the body. How tired will Angela Lee be now, having held that for close to a minute? Angela Lee slips out. May Yamaguchi slips out, lands a punch. Now it's about how tired Angela might be. Armbar possibility.
Yeah, but she knows what she's doing. She immediately got that arm away from the crotch. The elbow came up.
Heel to the face. We're in the final 5 seconds. This round has just raced by.
You've got to wonder what kind of energy she has after holding that position for more than 2 minutes. She was tempting that submission.
I think we're looking at Mei Yamaguchi's sister here on the left, just behind the Japanese flag. Can you imagine what they're feeling? The tension, the possibility that that fight could have been over in the first round, but how tired will Angela be? That was almost a minute, Mitch, holding that.
Yeah, Steve, once the fight goes to the ground, you never know. There's that beautiful transition. She jumped guard, pulled her into guard, and then ended up in mount with a beautiful transition. But that's the thing, you never know what to expect when Angela gets on the ground. The Lee family is so innovative when it comes to these submissions, and it's a threat from anywhere.
Mei Yamaguchi, she'll have heard, she'll have read about Angela Lee and the crazy things she does, the innovative way she goes about her game. She may well take something from the fact that she got out of that position and she survived it and she's into the second round. Let's see what she can do with it. That is what's on the line. A glimmering golden, silver, ruby studded ONE Championship world title belt. Second round.
Nice little confidence boost for me. Yamaguchi, she got out of the first round, defended some good submissions. But Angela's definitely in the lead because she had, you know, control. Nice little 1-2. Her punching looks sharp, especially when she has that reach advantage that she has to utilize.
Big high guard Angela has.
Elbows are a little wide, so it leaves her vulnerable to body kicks.
Oh, she got that leg up nice and high. Caught Angela Lee on the jaw.
You know, May is a third degree black belt.
Big right hand from Yamaguchi. Nice came swinging in. There was no hook to it at all. It was a straight overhand, almost bolo punch that caught Angela. But she's worked her way into possible trouble here as they swivel around.
Nice little outside trip to end up on the bottom as May is the one that reverses this one and ends up on top. May Yamaguchi has no fear of going to the ground with Angela Lee.
What can she do from this position, Mitch? Just trying to establish leg control there, aren't they?
Well, you can see how Angela's elevating the leg there. She's back into full guard. You know, the half guard position where you only have both legs wrapped around one leg, when you're in the top, a lot of people are preferring the ground and pound.
She's less likely to go for the submission than Angela would in this position. She's after the punches, the ground and pound, but she's pulled in nice and close. And this is where it gets difficult to land those punches because there's no distance between them, no leverage to land that punch.
Yeah, it really neutralizes the height advantage that Angela Lee has. You know, when they're on the ground like this, you know, you can use the long limbs or the long arms to slip in chokes, but it really nullifies any height and reach advantage that you have when the fight gets onto the ground. Everybody's almost the same size when it gets to the ground. May's on top now. landing shots. You got to be wondering, what's Angela thinking as far as the submissions that are coming? See how she opens her guard? She's not closing the guard. When the guard is closed, you're kind of locking the person into position. But when the guard's open, you're thinking about submissions.
You're thinking about it.
See how she immediately starts throwing up her legs. She's starting to think, going for arm bars, going for triangles, setting up sweeps. There it is. Just like that, she threw the leg over the head. Now there's a possible arm bar there. It's an awkward position. The arm is bent, so.
Crowd are really, really into this, aren't they? The arm bar's still very much there.
Yes, look at that. Look at that. She just toughs it out, pulls it out.
She doesn't look troubled at all.
It's high, though. Now she's in there.
She's got tremendous strength, though.
See,
this doesn't look too much of a problem for her.
When you're up in the air like that, you can't really crank your hips. You can't really pull them into position. But there's that sweep that we were talking about earlier tonight where you grab the feet and pull them down to the ground. Mays back up and pops right back up into the clinch.
The fans are just going wild on their feet, applauding behind us. You know, I was saying we haven't seen Angela Lee demonstrate the power of her punch. We also haven't seen much about how she can take a punch. I think Yamaguchi is going to test that tonight. She's come close already. Ground and pound looks the danger zone for Angela.
Angela Lee there with like the sacrifice throw. She threw, basically she got the clinch and she just kind of threw Yamaguchi on top. So she's definitely feeling much more comfortable when she's on her back. You know, you can see her threatening, you know, she immediately locks that hand into position, right? To nullify any punches that are coming, but then also when you hook the hands, you can start throwing your legs up for arm bars and triangles.
Angela's left hand controlling both of Yamaguchi's hand for a while, leaving the right elbow to just land shots at will. That changed, of course, pretty quickly. There's up punches there from Angela, but it's Yamaguchi on top. Is this surprising to you, Mitch? 9 minutes into this contest? Armbar again, perhaps.
That's it. And look at that. May just stands up, rips it out.
Oh, good, nice little hand. Angela was hurt by that.
Yeah, Steve, I am not surprised at all. That's why I'm saying people are underestimating, you know, that 73% that had the Facebook poll, you know, we're thinking Angela Lee is going to win. They're underestimating how legit and talented Yamaguchi is.
She has never been stopped in 24 professional fights. Never been stopped.
Look at that cradle. She grabs the leg, grabs the arm, and just controls her. In May's decision losses, she's been out grappled. And Angela is getting up these positions. You know, she's ending up possible. There's a choke. There's a choke of some sort, a possible guillotine. Good round for Yamaguchi.
Well, they're on their feet behind us here. It was hard for Mitch to keep up with exactly what was going on. A joke of some sort, it certainly was. She had her in trouble, there's no question. Mei Yamaguchi, if you weren't expecting much from her, I think you're now seeing how wrong you were.
Nice, she attempted the guillotine there. Angela tried to roll, and you can see how she laces up those legs, trapping Angela in position. The Singaporean crowd is very well acknowledged. They are so experienced. I mean, Singapore is turning into the mecca of Asian mixed martial arts here. And so this crowd knows exactly what's going on. Each of these transitions, beautiful techniques by both girls.
From Singapore, Mitch, around 75 countries around the world seeing this. Potentially 1 billion viewers. That's the reach, that's the interest that this fight, this inaugural Women's World Atomweight Championship in the one championship cage, that's the attention it's getting. These two women seemingly with the world at their feet. Who will come out with that glittering belt? 10 minutes down, 15 to go.
Ready?
Judges will score this fight in its entirety. It's not round by round. You don't get one round in the...
Oh!
What a big punch!
Oh,
Angela Lee in huge trouble from that overhand right that we signaled before the fight started. That's her big, big weapon. And Angela Lee has just tasted it. She has the presence of mind, though, to hold her hands around Yamaguchi's neck and pull her in, closing that distance.
What a shot by Yamaguchi. And immediately, Angela clinches it, keeps her wits about her, and goes for the tight guard to regain some composure. Now Yamaguchi is past her guard, and she's in side control. This is a bad position. Angela's still got to be rocked from that huge shot. She easily steps over into mount.
Round and pound now. A bucking bronco. Angela Lee tries to catapult her off, but it's a high position. The hammer blows come down, but Angela struggles.
Armbar. That's it. It's oh, what a transition. Deep. She's got to make sure she transitions. She can't let that thumb go up. If the thumb starts to go up, it's deep. Oh, she's got to fight it. She's got to roll. Steve, that's deep. That's a deep arm bar. Angela seems okay. Her arm is bending the wrong way, Steve.
She's not
but
tapping.
But she toughs it out.
Oh, my. The strength. This crowd is going crazy. The resolve from this woman. She's got out of it.
Oh, as she transitions into the back. Rear naked choke, possibly. But May looks okay. She's giving up the mount, though.
What a round this is. Have you seen a minute and a half like this ever before in your life?
Steve, to keep that composure, to keep that control, to keep the will alive, she was dropped by a big shot. Potential armbar almost snapped her arm in two, and now she's in top.
Back and forth.
Thrown off, but she's back on top.
There's just no form. There's no form to grasp onto, is there? It's back and forth. Swings and roundabouts. These two, tremendous entertainment for everyone here. I'm just looking around at the fans and we're all gasping for breath.
Steve, this is a shocker. Everybody in here is completely surprised at what is happening. Angela still has that will, that warrior spirit to keep pushing through. She's trying. Oh. She is proving she has a heart of a champion. Oh, it's a deep armbar.
Another armbar attempt.
Don't roll over on your back. She's got to stay up. Oh, see, now she see how the thumb's down. The thumb's down. She's out of trouble, but she's given up top position. Here come the punches.
Angela will look to pull her in close again to negate the value of those punches. Oh, Matt Hume, arrange a rematch now, please.
Look at that. She easily gets back into position. Good scrambling. You know, May is ending up on top. Knee bar. Drops into the knee bar. This is a bad position. Oh, it's okay. She's out. That's the exact thing to do. You want to negate that bar, go belly over, roll onto the side. Look at this. These transitions are ridiculous, Steve. Now she's possibly attacking the leg again. She's trying to dive under to roll out. Angela's on top.
1:45 left in this second round. You can barely pause for breath.
Up kick. Angela looking for that same sort of Darce choke right there that her brother got the victory with earlier today. See, you can see her clinching. She's got to work that hand up into the bicep to lock that in there. That's what she's doing.
It may well need that kind of ingenuity.
See, now, look at that. Beautiful technique by May. She grabs the leg to prevent the leg from lacing up and keeping her in position. Up knees to the head.
Using every single opportunity she can, Angela Lee, to gain an advantage. Knees to the head are damaging blows. Final minute of this third round. What a contest we're seeing here in Singapore.
That's the same submission her brother won with earlier tonight. It's that Darce choke. She's rolling. There's the roll. Now she's got to hook the leg. So she's got to take those legs and hook it. It'll lock in the choke. She's got 45 seconds. How tough is Mei Yamaguchi? Oh, it's broken, and she fights out of it again.
Tremendous resolve. What guts these women have, but also what technique.
There's a possible guillotine, modified, odd position sort of thing going on here.
I think I see what you're saying. 25 seconds left in this third round.
She's got to establish the position before attempting that submission, so May ends up on top. This is a very critical 15 seconds. This has been a back and forth round. What's that, a diamond cutter? What is that, like a WWE move that she's attempted there?
May still punching for all she can into the midriff of Angela Lee as the third round comes to an end. And I think we could all be grateful that there is more to come.
Oh, there's that big right
hand. That was just huge.
That dropped Angela Lee. And then May jumps on her and starts pounding on her. She gets into mount.
Look, but credit for the punch, but credit for taking it and
taking
it
the punch,
through the round.
Getting dropped, getting it caught in a deep arm bar. Where this could have been it. A lot of people would have given up right here, but no, Angela Lee came back and actually had some very significant submission attempts in that round. But due to the big almost knockout versus the almost submissions, I don't even know how many possible submissions we had in that round.
These women have rubber arms and blistering fists. What a right hand that was from Mei Yamaguchi, 33 years old. Remember, she's never been stopped. Well, she's done more than survive 15 minutes with Angela Lee here. We have potentially another 10 minutes to come. Thereafter, somebody, Mitch, will have that world championship belt strapped around their waist. Who's ahead so far?
After three rounds, almost knocked out, big drop with that punch. I gotta give a slight advantage to Yamaguchi.
Long way
after
to go.
That, after the 15 minutes, but now we're in the championship rounds. Now, Yamaguchi has been, you know, into these deep rounds. You know, she's fought some tough people.
Remember her experience, how seasoned she is. Oh, good trip from Lee. We're back down on the deck. But these two will work at every moment to improve their position. To transition from a point of vulnerability to a point of advantage.
You know, this is uncharted territory, I think, for both these women. I might be wrong, but Yamaguchi has never, you know, seen the fourth
Certainly
round.
Angela
Lee. Possible ankle lock here. You know, she's attempted the heel hook. You know, she's rolling with it. Yamaguchi's gonna do the right thing, interlaces the legs. You know, she's gotta turn, she's gotta try to get out of that. Looks like she's out of danger. There's a possible heel hook where you kind of just interlace the arm, like the hook of your arm inside the ankle, and you kind of crank on the knee ligaments here. This is a very dangerous game that they're playing right here.
Impervious to leg locks and arm bars, though, Mei Yamaguchi.
24 fights, never been finished, even. She's given up the bag, but she's okay with it. You know, she just kind of rolls over.
Contest this
arm triangle possibly here. You know, she's answering the phone, how she kind of puts her hand up by the, this is it. This is an arm triangle. Well, I think she's gonna have to put Yamaguchi to sleep if she wants to finish this. Mei Yamaguchi's gotta keep her hand, you know, close to her ear and try to pry some space away because Angela's in mount. Now she's gonna jump to the side and kind of work her way around. That's an arm triangle. We saw it with Hodger Gracie earlier.
She's scooting around, trying to get the best position she can to make it as tight as possible. I don't see Yamaguchi tapping ever.
Yeah, you know, she's doing the right thing. Now her arms, she's kind of out of danger. You know, she's trying to push on the arm.
Oh, she's pushing it.
But Angela's in the right spot. You know, she's completely into side control. That arm's deep. You know, you gotta wonder what's gonna happen here.
Olivier Cost is primed. Ready to pounce and separate these two if he thinks the fight's over. Oh, she comes back
See,
with punches.
She's not tapping. No,
that's what
punches.
She's saying. I'm still alive, ref. I'm still here.
You know, usually some of the fighters give us a thumbs up. Yeah. But, yep, she's fine.
Don't you dare call it on my behalf. I'm still in this. And
she overpowers her and up on top. Angela could take the back here, but her arm's kind of in a precarious, sort of odd position. Uh-oh, there's a triangle here. She can stuff her arm.
Got a long way to go with that, though, to get that all the way around.
No, she's just got to hook her foot with that leg. That's all she's got to do is push that arm down, and there it is.
Oh, now she switched it.
Beautiful.
And that's a much better position for her. She changed legs, saw the opening, and transitioned double quick time.
She's hooking that leg. Now she's coming over onto the side. That's a deep triangle, Steve.
Yamaguchi's throat has taken so much punishment and torque in this contest.
Will Angela Lee capture the Women's World Championship and be the first person to stop Mei Yamaguchi here with that triangle? But she's kind of out. I don't know how deep that is.
She just seems to generate enough space to just survive, doesn't she, in these locks?
That's also another thing about being compact like she is.
Yeah.
Look at she bites out.
Tremendous effort. She's done it to the applause of everybody here at cage side.
Takedown, ends up on top. Some punches, she's got a minute left to work here.
Entering the final 60 seconds of round 4, the championship rounds, we're well into them. and we're thoroughly enjoying them. 75 countries around the world tuning into this.
That's a lot of submission attempts. This round has been all Angela Lee, and maybe enough to edge her into the lead as far as the scoring is concerned. She jumps into the guillotine, but you gotta wonder, at what point does she go, okay, I'm gonna stop trying for submissions, and I'm gonna punch you in the face.
Submission attempt after submission attempt, and Mei Yamaguchi is just not gonna give any ground. She seems to find that gap to give her a little bit of wiggle room to survive. There's no way she's gonna tap. This pace, though, from both women is relentless.
But the thing is they're constantly pushing. They're constantly going forward. They're, you know, this is the true epitome of world championship grappling right here, that they're both consistently working. And this might be enough to move Angela Lee ahead in the scoring. We might have two rounds each.
And it's just because of so many submission attempts.
Yeah, I mean, they're still attacking. Even if on your back, you know, the way that, you know, one championship scores fights is that attempted submissions are, you're showing you are actively progressing the finish. And that round was clearly Angela Lee's. Here she goes.
Angela Lee is a young woman. She's 19 years old. She's facing a seasoned prodigy who's 33. Into the fifth round, uncharted territory for Lee.
Uncharted territory for both women, and we don't judge fights round by round, you know, so it's not like it's 2-2 or it's, you know, it's very close. It's all about this fifth round. Who wants it more? Who is gonna push forward and capture the first ever world championship here in the women's division?
That whistle signals that the seconds need to get out of the cage and leave just the referee and our two world title contenders for the final 5 minutes of this inaugural One Championship World Atomweight title at the Singapore Indoor Stadium in front of 12,000 very appreciative fans, all on their feet and applauding as these women face the final lap.
This is it, Steve. You gotta wonder who's gonna reach inside of themselves and find that special moment, that little burst that they need to catapult them into worldwide fame. If Angela Lee comes away, it's her destiny. It's what she was born to do. If Yamaguchi does it, then she shocks the world and becomes the One Championship Women's Atomweight Champion.
Taking some encouragement from the way she started that third round with that huge right hand. She started there with a left, right, left. Knowing that perhaps she has the advantage in the stand-up. If she can get inside that longer reach of Angela Lee, as she did then with a stiff jab, then she might be able to do some damage. Because when they've gone downstairs, the pattern has been submission attempts from Lee, survived by Yamaguchi, but the point scoring in that scenario surely goes Lee's way. Left hand from Yamaguchi, and I think she's hurt.
Yeah, Yamaguchi's looking a bit fatigued. She's not really throwing the punches with the same sort of, you know, power or emphasis.
She threw that one and backed off, didn't she? Something hurt her there, and she's starting to look perhaps a little bit tired. Knees to the body from Angela.
Angela Lee is in a prime spot. She might be sensing that little bit of weakness, that blood in the water where she's just jumping all over it. Yamaguchi's just not fighting off the same. You know, does Angela Lee have enough gas left in her tank to finish?
Women have put each other through the mill.
She's trying to take that outside leg there with the trip and drag her down to the ground where she's more comfortable, it looks.
Entering into the 23-minute mark. Left jab from Angela Lee was a good one, and I think that hurt May. She sent in a little left hand of her own without even looking at it. It was a no-look punch, and it landed.
She just left, drops right. Her chin. Caution to the wind, puts it all in there, the Hail Mary.
Yeah, that's exactly what they are from Mei Yamaguchi. Right hand from her, not crisp, but it landed. A thudding kind of blow. The kick from Angela, not quite high enough. Good left
kicks.
Hand from Angela as Mei Yamaguchi came in, and down they go. The takedown.
It's been a scramble. That's been the story of this entire fight, is the scrambling.
2.5 minutes left.
Angela Lee is on the side control here as, you know, Yamaguchi's trying to bridge out of it, trying to walk along the cage to create us another scramble.
Angela has a knee on a midriff, just pinning her down there, restricting her movement, containing her ability to move around and slide away.
This could be enough. She's controlling the position. If she remains in this position, or at least on top for the next 2 minutes, we could see Angelique capture the ONE Championship title. She's got a possible triangle here. She stepped over the leg there, but she's not really, doesn't really have the arm.
At the 15 minute
she doesn't
mark.
Have the arm. It's not really a triangle. It's just kind of like an uncomfortable head squeeze.
At the 15 minute mark, we may well have had Mei Yamaguchi slightly ahead. Angela Lee probably pulled herself ahead at the end of the 20 minute mark. We have 90 seconds left in this contest. Again, Olivier Coste is looking carefully, asking the question, are you ready to throw it in? I think I know the answer. Nothing's gonna stop, yeah. Nothing's gonna stop her.
There's a possible arm lock on the right side of Yamaguchi. She could threaten a possible Kimura, but the head is just cut, that triangle position that she's got on the head is just kind of holding her there and making it uncomfortable. And
even if she just continues to hold this position for the rest of the fight, surely it's one that's an advantage for Angela Lee, and the judges will see it that way. Mei Yamaguchi at the moment is only defending. Angela Lee showing her youth and probably superior cardio.
Oh, there's the arm triangle again. You know, she's doing the right thing by pushing it away. She's got 38 seconds to become the first person to finish Yamaguchi. It's there. She's still attempting the submissions and going after it.
It's a relentless assault as we enter the final 20 seconds of this contest.
That's an arm triangle right there, Steve. You can see the lips kind of going blue a little bit on Yamaguchi, but I think she's okay. She's just so tough.
She is, isn't she? There's no way she's going to cave in. She would have done that a long time ago if that was the case. Final 5 seconds of this totally enthralling contest that has been tremendous value for all of the fans here at Cadeside. The bell goes. Angela Lee walks away to a corner. Yamaguchi pulls herself off the canvas and has a little walk around to loosen her limbs. The crowd here absolutely loved what they saw. 25 minutes into it, a quick recap of the entire fight, Mitch. Who had the judges given this fight to? What do you think?
It's so close at this point, but that was like, there's another attempted submission. You know, she's got a deep arm triangle. You can see how, you know, Yamaguchi kind of creates space so that the choke's not quite deep into it. When you go for the arm triangle, you're essentially choking the person with their own arm. And it was so close, you know, but that final round, you know, could have been enough to give Angela Lee the nod, but that big knockdown, that was the most dramatic point of the entire fight.
Look
when she
how,
got hit.
Look how exhausted she is. Angela Lee put absolutely everything into that. Relentless attack, relentless submission attempts. It's so draining to hold a submission hold like some of those that she had, particularly in that second round where she just clung on. Yamaguchi was not giving up, but she kept it going. That, by the way, is Angela Lee's mom, waiting as we all are.
To present a prize for this fight, we have Mr. Takashi Tepe, Casio Singapore Assistant General Manager of Timepiece Division. Before anything else, ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for your warriors! Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all 3 judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. And now, the ONE Women's Atomweight World Champion, Angela Twister Sister Lee!
Capital of neighborhood to
ready.
Take the bout back to the USA. First round set for 5. Stan Fairtex in the blue. Round kick early there from Janet Todd. Checks the low kick. kickboxing in the larger gloves here. High kick there from Jenna Todd. We know she can knock opponents out with that rear leg round kick looped around the neck.
But it's also how she sets it up. She'll start chopping down those legs, show stamp a few of the leg kicks, and then start going headhunting.
Jenna Todd, nice hook to an outside leg kick. Stamp returns the favor, tries for a hook of her own. Hook there from Janet Todd. Double jab, right cross there from Janet. Slings in the leg kick. Stamp goes up to the left rib cage. Good three punch combination. Stinging punches there from Janet. Eats a short right hand from Stamp Fairtex. Janet wants to get inside the phone booth here. Cracking leg kicks from both women.
You can see they're trading leg kicks, but Janet's just being a little bit faster, really pushing forward, being aggressive from the start. Stamp's trying to get that rhythm, trying to find that pace that she likes, and Janet's not giving her that opportunity.
You know, when they competed last time, and Janet had that respect early on for Stamp Fairtex. No respect for her here tonight so far. Coming straight on the aggression, straight on the attack, is Janet Todd from the opener. Looping left hand there from Stamp Fairtex. Janet, left hand to a high kick, comes close. Nicely done from the American. Stamp comes forward. Janet gets out of dodge. Been a good round for Todd so far. Jab two there from Stamp.
Janet's putting the combination just a little bit, you know, more together by putting them together in bunches. Little, but not just two punches, not just three. She's going three punches, leg kick, mixing things up. Stamp's got to level up right now.
For an American to beat a tie and take a world title back to the USA would be phenomenal. A major accomplishment, especially the biggest world title in the world. And as you said, she's beating Stamp to the punch to the kick so far here in the opening round. Circles off counterclockwise.
Stamp does her best work when her opponent stands right in front of her and able to tee off on her. But Janet's not doing that. Janet's doing a lot of lateral movement. She's not standing still, but she's consistently moving back and forth.
Janet the faster of the two at the moment. Stamp the more flat-footed of the two. Jab there, lead hand from Fairtex. Jab from Janet, overhand right from Stamp. Left hook, tried to throw that one down to the rib cage, did Fairtex. Fires out the front kick. Still trying to find her distance and her rhythm here, Stamp Fairtex. Nice evasion from Janet, good head movement from Janet.
One more bigger.
Spot on defense so far from Janet Tider. And we go to the towels at the end of one.
That was a good first round for JT. She immediately got off to a fast start, but putting these combinations together, you can see she circles off to the weak side, gets back into the center, lands a nice little leg kick, but then doesn't stand still, doesn't stand right where the combination ends. She immediately starts circling out, and a beautiful little clinch there, an evasion and a redirect. Still just getting used to each other, testing the waters, but this is basically round six, and they just changed gloves. They're going right from the five-round war that they went to right into this one.
Three judges, circle side, are scoring on a 10-point must system. Who do you think won the first round, folks? Do you have a 10-9 Janet Tide? Do you have a 10-9 for Stamp Fairtex? Also, don't forget, in one Super Series, there can be no draws. We must have a winner.
Okay.
Second round inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Our main event of one championship, time. King of the Jungle.
Box.
The world atomweight kickboxing title on the line. Held by Stamp Fairtex, right of screen. Challenger Janet Todd from the USA. Long reach on the cross there from Stamp. Nice jab to hook to outside leg kick there from Janet Todd. Speed again favoring Janet Todd, and the angles, a little pirouette, a little quarter turned that Janet is taking. High kick there from Todd.
Right hand.
Catch and counter from Stamp Fairtex.
That's where Stamp does good work. You can't catch and take steps. You have to catch and then throw a legal technique to get one step before you throw.
Janet Todd circling off to her right, staying away from the power side of Stamp. Jab two there from Stamp. Todd with a fake. Stamp thought about leading with a left hook. Gloves are high, as well they should be, as Janet continues to try and ring her bell with that high round kick. Stamp goes downstairs. required in both corners here. Outside leg kick from Stab. Now some instructions from Team Fairtex.
The movement of Janet Todd seems to be giving Stamp a little bit of problems. She can't pinpoint the location of Janet Todd, so she's not able to connect cleanly. Janet's constantly moving laterally.
Inside leg kick from Stamp. Janet just looks the sharper of the two so far. Certainly the faster. And Stamp, here in the second round, to me, Mitch, looks a little more sluggish. There's a good right hand, but it's not as snappy and it's not as aggressive as we're used to seeing from Stamp.
Well, that's what we saw in the first match. We saw Stamp constantly push forward, aggressive with the hands, multi-shot combinations. But again, she's been transitioning into mixed martial arts, where you have an entirely different skill set to learn. Now, Janet Todd has only been striking. She's been getting faster, she's been getting more accurate, she's been putting people down, she's been knocking people out. And we're starting to see that here. Nice leg kick landed by Stamp, though.
The trajectory, the 45-degree angle, cutting down on that leg kick was superb, and already some reddening on the lead thigh of Janet Todd. Todd thought about the inside thigh, the femoral profunda. Pokes out that jab. Now Stamp comes forward, may find a target on that lead leg that she'd like to go to off her back leg. Cracks away to the waist there of Janet Todd.
That right kick is her a huge weapon for Stamp Fairtex. She cannot just focus on boxing. She has to add those kicks into the equation.
Smiles at Janet. Cracks away the legs again to Stamp Fairtex. Jab two. Janet goes the round kick. Very good opening round for Janet Todd. Close round here in the second though. And we go to the towels. Once again, folks, let us know how you're scoring and follow us on your social media at One Championship on Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram.
See, these are the combinations. There she's going, doubling up on the head kick. Beautiful combination by Janet. Set up the head kick, saw an opening, went right back to it. But in the last minute of that round, Stamp Fairtex started to land kicks. She was touching that leg of Janet and padding a little bit of power to it. Stamp needs to shake this off and start with the volume, start to speed up. Because those leg kicks are gonna swear down Janet Todd's legs, are gonna slow her down in the later rounds and impair that movement. Stamp Fairtex needs to keep going after those legs and land those big shots.
Third round of five for the ONE Super Series Atomweight World Kickboxing Championship. Stamp Fairtex the champ, the challenger Janet Todd. Inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Janet has been fast, has been precise. Stamp did start to power up in the second round. Nice right hand there. Step through with it from Stamp, then goes downstairs. Switch round kick was a beauty there from Janet Todd. Circles away from Stamp's power side. Needs to check those leg kicks, of course, and Stamp goes to her lead side. They clinch up now. And referee Delapsis breaks them. Stamp gloves are high. She knows the capability and the head kicks of Janet Todd. Good jab to outside thigh kick. No talk though on the thigh kick. Thigh kick there from Janet. Outside leg kick from Stamp. Janet goes upstairs. A real contrast in kicking styles and kicking targets between these two. It's Stamp going downstairs, Janet going upstairs. Resets here to Stamp. Janet again, drifting away from the power side. Trying to poke that left hand out for the round kick. Catch and counter there from Stamp, and again, just a caution from referee Delapsis.
See, that's what you cannot do in kickboxing. You can do it in Muay Thai, but you cannot catch and throw the technique. You have to catch, let go, and then throw. That's the difficulty of competing in all these different sports, because we have so many different options and rule sets to compete in. Makes it beautiful to watch, but it's hard for the athletes to make those adjustments.
Who will be first to go here? Probing left hand there from Stamp Fairtex. Janet probes with the left of her own. Stamp trying to develop some speed on that lead hand now.
You see the lead leg of Janet Todd starting to get a little bit red, a little bit torn from those leg kicks that Stamp Fairtex keeps landing. You can see Stamp Fairtex kind of builds to a crescendo as she goes through, picking up speed and volume as the match goes on and adding that power. Janet Todd has kept a constant pace through the entire match so far.
Outside leg kick from Stamp, again attacking that lead thigh, just above the left knee, that common peroneal nerve. Janet's digging to the body now, going for the liver of Stamp Fairtex. Round kick to the leg again from Stamp. One way to slow down the boxing of Janet Todd is to take apart her left. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet, travels up the legs. So if you can take out the legs of the opponent, you can slow down the boxing. Certainly limit the effectiveness of the punches.
Janet Todd just eating these leg kicks. I'd like to see her step into some of these leg kicks and start throwing that right hand right down the middle. She's got to either check them or step into some of these punches.
What are your thoughts here, Mitch, on Janet going for the liver shot extensively in this round?
I like digging to the liver. Those body shots are usually something we don't see Stamp Fairtex opponents going after. And you can see her start landing some of these body shots. But what she's doing is scoring points with those body shots. Check this out. Came forward, lands a beautiful little jab, and then again sticks that leg kick in there. Janet Todd trying to mix things up, but then started attacking the body. The headshots really weren't working for Janet Todd in that third round, so what'd she do? Latter part of the round, she starts attacking the body, digging the kicks in, and shooting that little left hook right into the liver.
Do you give it 10-9 to Stamp? Do you give it 10-9 to Janet Todd? Right. Intriguing contest for the Adam Way Kickboxing World Title. Penultimate round, 4 of 5.
Not good. Good.
We see the aggression, the power upping from Stamp Fairtex over the last two rounds. Is Janet Todd slowing due to the trauma she's taken to the lead thigh from those leg kicks? Jab there from Janet. Right hand, and again Stamp Fairtex goes to that quadriceps area. Janet's looking for the liver. But I believe these leg kicks, Mitch, are taking their toll.
Yeah, you can see her lateral movement is just not the same as it was in the first and second. Janet's a little bit more stationary, and every single exchange, Stamp Fairtex is just landing last. In Muay Thai, that means a lot, but she's punctuating each exchange by digging into that leg kick.
On the inside, no elbows allowed, of course. Some of these kickboxing rules. Janet breaks off. Stamp goes for that left thigh again. Couldn't connect on that occasion.
That's what Janet's got to do. After the exchange, she has to get moving. She cannot just back up inside Stamp's kicking range. She's got to get away outside of the kicking range of Stamp.
Under 2 minutes remaining. Combination there from Stamp. Didn't have the exclamation mark with the leg kick she was hoping for. Janet round kick. Nice one to the upper left rib cage. There's a head kick from the American. And again, Stamp goes back to that thigh. There's another one from Stamp. Make it 3 in a row from the champion.
You can see that Stamp is okay to eat a high kick just to answer back with that leg kick. And she is digging into it now.
Long-reaching jab from Stamp, a sliding jab from the champion. Janet tries to get off center, work an uncanny angle. Janet drifting, doesn't go first. Stamp does, and she lands another leg kick. These leg kicks are all going to score for Stamp Fairtex. Good check against the round kick from Janet Todd. Janet has certainly slowed down. I believe it's the toll taken from the punishment to the lead leg. You can see the welts now, a slight shade of color on the lead thigh. Janet Todd, who rips away to that liver section again, and Stamp backs her off with a right hand.
Stamp's okay to eat a couple of these punches. Just let Janet Todd get into that close range, and as soon as she does, she's scoring with that leg kick. Just like that, she baits her in. Once she's in that kicking range, she starts to drop those leg kicks. Over and over again.
Janet Todd had an ultra impressive opening round. Then in the second round, Stamp Fairtex began to find range with a leg kick. She upped the power in the third, and she's not relenting here in the fourth. Stamp Fairtex, and Janet on the inside. A little bit of a shot to the jaw there.
We will go into the fifth and final. It will still be anyone's match for the taking. Janet Todd needs to defend those leg kicks and counter off them as the champion pumps her fists into the air.
Nice, Jen tried to step in to that big hook. Couldn't get the hook, but a beautiful head kick landed by Janet Todd, and then Stamp starts going after the legs. That was what Janet needs to do. Nice little switch of stances, backed up out of range, but then Stamp was able to score again with the leg kicks. And that's what we're seeing most in the fourth round, just over and over again, touching each leg over and over again at the end of each exchange, and you can see that welt start to build up on the leg of Janet Todd. Gotta get that ice on that leg, reduce some of that swelling, get that mobility back. She is still in this. It could be two apiece right now, Michael.
As Run DMC's tricky plays between rounds, Janet Todd needs to pull out some tricks now. She needs to be tricky, work some angles that Stamp won't expect. She cannot stand and trade in front of Stamp Fairtex. Fifth and final round. It may very well be even going into this fifth and final. But Stamp Fairtex has really been powering up since the second after Janet Todd's stunning first round. Jab from Janet. There's the leg kick again from Stamp Fairtex. And Janet's not checking up. Goes high. She'll go for the headache maker. Try and loop the shin around the back of the neck. See if she can catch Stamp Fairtex. See if she can drop the champion. And Stamp backs her off. Big right hand to an outside thigh kick from the champ.
You can see the head kicks of Janet Todd just aren't there anymore because she can't plant on that lead leg to wrap that right leg around the head of Stamp Fairtex. Stamp is, you can see her game plan is starting to unfold. Break down the legs, chop down JT, and then start going after the head with the hands. That's usually JT's strategy.
Nice power salvo again off the rear hand from Stamp Fairtex. Orthodox stance here for Stamp, pumps out the jab. Let's see if she goes back to that leg kick to the elite guy. Alice Talopsis wants to see some more engagement here. Janet comes forward. Stamp fires the right. There's the leg kick. The company bang on the kisser with that right hand. And there's the power again from the champion. Janet gets backed off with the left hand. Nicely done from Stamp. Her corner applauds us.
Janet's having success inside that boxing ring. Those straight punches coming right down the middle are scoring for Janet Todd. She needs more of that. Stay out of that leg kick range and start letting those hands go.
Stamp went body, then went head. Janet Todd trying to cut off the movement of the champion. 1:15 remains, final round here for the Atomweight Kickboxing World title. Oh, nice stiff left hand there from Janet. Jab two, misses the target, just falls short. Left hand meets left hand. It was stamping through the short straw. High kick there from Janet Todd. A nice stiff jab again from Janet. Then drifts out of the way of the counter. See, under a minute to go, fifth and final round, Dragon.
The boxing of Janet Todd is having success. She's finding a home for those punches. That is a beautiful little hook to landing. She's got to keep that volume on.
Swinging wildly with the right hand there. Stamp Fairtex comes forward and goes after that lead leg. That damaged lead leg of Janet Todd. And again, Stamp Fairtex plows in. There's the overhand right from Stamp. And Janet backs off. The champion coming on strong. 25 seconds remaining. Here comes Stamp Fairtex. Goes body, goes head. And referee Delapsis breaks them. Stamp glances towards the corner. 18 seconds on the clock now.
Anybody's game right now, ladies and gentlemen. Stamp has done a lot of good work, scoring a lot of good points with those leg kicks, but Janet's starting to have success.
Here comes
hands.
Janet! Janet Todd straight line punches down the center, and Stamp bounces back, goes again to that lead thigh. The high kick, the final high kick. What a war, what a match. Tremendous contest between two amazing athletes.
Stamp Fairtex again. She started slow, but then just kept coming. Janet got a little bit off balance there, but Stamp just kept pouring it on. Lands a nice little double right hand there on the exchange. Janet coming back at the end, flurrying with the punches, realizing she might be behind, pushes forward, letting the hands go. Landed a few shots right there. Stamp answered right back. What an atomweight title tilt.
How do you have it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, in over 150 countries, do you have it, Stan Fairtex? Do you have it, Janet Todd? Certainly in the first round, Janet Todd came out and performed spectacularly. But she could not keep the momentum going. Stamp started to find range with that. Kicked to the lead by in the second. Powered up with it in the third. Started trading some heavy salvos with the hand in the fourth. And the more punishment Jenna took to that lead by, the more difficult it was for her to throw the head kick. We've gone to a decision. There can be no draw in one Super Series. We must have a winner. There is a criteria for the judges to score by. Still, okay, let's go now to Dom Lau with the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have once again, Mr. Chatri Sichotong. And now, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision and new one Super Series Atomweight Kickboxing World Champion, Janet Todd!
The time for talk is over. Angela Lee, Zhong Jinnan Lee, the Atomweight World Champion. Zhong Jinnan, the Strawweight World Champion. Both come out slinging the hands. Zhong Jinnan may have the edge in power in the hands. Angela will have the edge on the ground. Overhand there from Zhong Jinnan, trying to back up Angela Lee. Goes to the body. You feel Zhong Jinnan isn't quite settled here yet. Inside the opening 30 seconds, looks a little more jittery than Angela Lee.
Angela Lee's very composed. She's been there. She's been in these moments a long time, so she knows what to do, even at such a young age. The Lee clan has told me that Zhong Jinnan gets disrupted when she gets hit. She starts to flurry. She starts to get wild when she gets touched up. And that's what Angela Lee's planning on doing. She wants to touch up the face of Zhong Jinnan and get her to overcommit and then lead to the takedown. Right now, she's inside the clinch. Let's see what Zhong Jinnan can do.
Angela Lee, Atomweight World Champion, 9-0, undefeated. Zhong Jinnan goes to ground for the very first time. Top position for Angela Lee.
Takedown by Angela Lee. Let's see what she can do now in side control.
And a pin that right arm of the champion and bangs away to the face between the eyes of Zhong Jinnan.
This is a bad spot for Zhong Jinnan. She's got to be composed. She's got to stay relaxed. She's got to try to work her way back into half guard, which she does. Now she's got to try to get an underhook on that side of where Angela Lee is. Angela Lee right now has an underhook on the right side of Zhong Jinnan. So she has to try to get that underhook. She has to try to swim her right arm underneath the arm of Angela Lee and start to work her way up the cage. Angela Lee has tremendous top pressure.
Angela Lee right in front of her corner, her father and head coach Ken Lee, also her brother Christian Lee in the corner. You see them both there on the right of your screen. Her husband Bruno Pucci watching back in Hawaii on BR Live and TNT. Big hello to Bruno Pucci.
Breathe, Bruno.
On her back here, the champion, Zhong Jinnan of China, who trains out of Bali MMA in Indonesia these days with Big Mike Clay, Don Carlo Klaus, and all the team there.
Good
one
job.
Of their main sparring partners for this one was Tiffany Van Soest, who's also here in Tokyo.
Good job by Zhong Jinnan to get her feet on the hips of Angela Lee and create a little bit of space. Angela Lee's jumping on the neck now. Possible front headlock. Let's see, Zhong Jinnan's got to separate those hands. Works her way back up to the feet. In a bad spot for some knees. Angela Lee's looking for possibly a darce choke. She's got an opportunity here to slide her left arm onto her own bicep and clasp on a choke. Might just choose to soften her up with the knees right now.
It's set for five rounds for the women's strawweight world title, but most pundits say it won't go that far. Gut-munching knee there from Zhong Jinnan, the champion, and she breaks away from the left hook.
Nice little confidence boost from Zhong Jinnan to get back up to her feet. You can see the way she celebrated by clapping her hands. Now she's trying to shake out her hands.
I wonder if Jean's trying to play a counter game here with Angela. Wants Angela to strike first. Seems to be that way. Gets it with a nice left hand there to Zhong Jinan. Another left hand for the champion. And circles off counterclockwise. Drops the lead hand down to the bread basket. Now drifts off in the opposite direction. Angela ties her up again. Takes a knee to the upper left ribs.
Zhong Jinan's got to be careful in these clinch positions. She's allowing Angela to close too much distance. She has to circle around. She has to create movement. She has to create that chaos. Headlock takedown now. Zhong Jinan might be able to pop her head out. Good job. Get back into the separation.
Zhong Jinan threw a knee, broke off there. Let's see if she can get the power salvos off her hands now. Zhong Jinan, the punching panda. Saw it come out on an absolute blaze when she entered one championship, tearing up Abriel Senio and then demolishing Tiffany Teo on her way to win that world title. Big right hand for the punching panda. Here she comes.
Nice right hands.
Angela Lee got her first real taste of Zhong Jinan's power in that right hand, bitch.
Yeah, Zhong Jinan answered those right hands with shots of her own.
Circling again. Counterclockwise is the champion. Good left hook, then rips down the liver, overhand right into the number clover.
Angela Lee's doing a good job, though, of cutting the angles of Zhong Jinan. You can see that pressure. She's trying to move in, get into that clinch, and work for that takedown. Zhong Jinan's trying to circle out, but Angela Lee's doing a good job of cutting her off. Looks like we might see a second round here, Michael.
Angela did predict she would finish Zhong Jinan in the first. I don't think we're going to see that. Both women landing right hands. It was maybe Angela who drew the short straw. Thought about a front kick, did Lee. And we go to the towels at the end of one.
On the ground, this is where Angela is most dangerous. Look at her. She's got that front headlock position. She lands a nice knee to the left side of the face of Zhong Jinan. There's Zhong Jinan throwing that overhand right, catches the shoulder of Angela Lee. Angela Lee's doing a good job of defending. Zhong Jinan needs to mix things up a little bit. Constant movement, not allow Angela Lee to back her up into the cage. I like Angela Lee working into that clinch and dragging her down. She's got that nice little headlock takedown that she's using very effectively to put Zhong Jinan on her back and soften her up. Good round for Angela Lee.
Hey,
we are ready to rock and roll. Second round, set for five for the world strawweight title. The atomweight world champion, Angela Lee. The strawweight world champion, Zhong Jinan. The sold-out Rio Goku Goku Kikan. Great choice for the first ever event of one championship in Japan. No greater building of martial arts history than here at the Rio Goku Koku Gikan. Its hallowed hallways have been built by so many great martial arts champions over the years. Corking knee there from Zhong Jinan. Angela turns her around nicely, backs the champ against the cage.
She's very tight in that clinch position. She's got her hands locked. She might try to step over inside, take her right leg across the body, and throw Zhong Jinan down again. Zhong Jinan's got to try to swim in. She's got to create a little bit of space on that right side. She has to try to get her arm on underneath the arm of Angela Lee and break away.
Hey there from Zhong Jinan.
I see somebody turn the corner here, a little bit of redirection here.
Is Zhong Jinan playing the right game at the moment, Mitch?
Well, I don't know if it's the right game, but she's doing okay, and she's been able to get out of a few bad positions that Angela Lee's had her in. Now, Angela Lee is a black belt. She's submitted a lot of people, and Zhong Jinan's done a good job of keeping her composure and working her way back up to her feet. I'd like to see Zhong Jinan start throwing hands and then maybe some kicks. Soften up the legs, throw those leg kicks to Angela Lee, and then circle out. She's allowing Angela Lee to back her up against the cage inside these clinch positions, but she's able to escape and create space. So that's going to build her confidence.
The space allows the strike, which is the power side of Zhong Jinan. Will she strike first? Does she want to play the counter game here with Angela Lee? Looking through her brow, threads the right hand. Lee, nicely done to cut off the movement of the champion. Looks for the right hand as Lee. Couldn't find it, resets herself. How do you see Lee carrying herself so far with this extra weight, Mitch, going up a weight division here to strawweight?
I think she looks great at strawweight. She was happy, she was composed all week, and she's gonna be stronger, but you gotta wonder, how did that back injury play into things? The back is involved in so many aspects of mixed martial arts, especially when you have a grappler the strength of Angela Lee, how is that going to affect her game? And that could be part of the reason, I don't want to speculate, but part of the reason why Zhang Jinan's been able to escape a lot of these close encounters.
They were scheduled to compete against each other in November last year in Singapore. A bulging disc in the back of Angela Lee prevented that. And here we are in Tokyo tonight in the biggest card in history. One championship, a new era. Angela Lee backed against the cage, knees to the thigh there from Zhang Jinan. Lee turns her around.
Good job. That now she's working the underhook. See how she swam that arm in? Now she's got controls. I'd like her to jack that arm up. Otherwise, she might go for a ride here. Angela Lee's been able to drag her to the ground twice now. Good adjustment on the body position there from Zhang Jinan. Let's see if Angela Lee can get her down. Oh, a takedown attempt there from Zhang Jinan. She exits with a punch.
Zhang Jinan, an opportunity to work the hands. There's a nicely threaded overhand lead there. Circles off to her right, away from the power side of Angela.
Zhang Jinan looks a little bit stiffer than we've seen her in the past. You can see her shoulders are kind of shrugged up next to her ears. I don't know if that's a defensive tactic to far as rolling with the punches and, you know, using the shoulder to block it, but she looks a little bit stiffer than we've seen her in the past.
Mitch and Eve. Chance that part of the plan of Zhang Jinan may be to draw Angela into really deep water and test Angela at strawweight.
I mean, it makes sense. You know, it could be that Angela may start to fade in the later rounds. That's what they're hoping for. They're hoping to draw this out to see a third, fourth, and fifth round because they're hoping that Angela Lee, after her back injury, after her car accident, hasn't been able to put the time in on the mat, and that could be when Zhang Jinan chooses to step it up a level and really start pushing the pace, because she seems very composed and relaxed. She's not breathing heavy, neither of them are. And Angela Lee doesn't look to be fading at all.
Still great to see the hashtag One Championship trending tops in the USA right now on Twitter. Has been for the last hour and a half or so. Great to see. Big hello to all of our American viewers watching on TNT. Outside leg kick there from Angela. Roundhouse kick from Zhang Jinan. Under 30 seconds remain. Second round of five. Could it be the master plan of Zhang Jinan to draw Angela Lee to deep water? Test Lee's cardio. Test that extra weight. Step upside kick there. Zhang Jinan tries to back her off with the right hand. There's a left hook from the champion. And an inside thigh kick. She talks to Angela. She pulls her forward. Angela's not going to be sucking into a brawl. She's too clever for that. We're going into another round.
Look at this. Inside the clinch, Angela's doing good work. Look at that over-the-top elbow. Had the arm come down on Zhang Jinan. She was able to land a nice overhand elbow there. And then Zhang Jinan was finally able to have some success inside the clinch. Look at that beautiful little trip there from Zhang Jinan. She answers or exits with a punch. Good job from both these ladies in that round. We're starting to see them. You know, this is when that cardio is going to start to come into play. You know Zhang Jinan can go hard for five rounds. Angela Lee has gone hard five rounds in the past, but how is it right now?
If you want to win an all expenses paid VVIP experience at One Championship, find out how now. Go to onefc.com/win. onefc.com/win and find out how you can win a very, very important person's experience.
Ready?
Third round of five for the strawweight world title. Angela Lee in the black, looking to become the first ever two-division women's champion at One Championship. Zhang Jinan looking to retain. A little more gusto behind both these martial arts champions here to start the third. Angela presses the champ against the cage.
Right now, Zhang Jinan's trying to get that underhook on that one side. You can see she's trying to go for a body lock. Angela's got her pressed up against the cage. She's got that driving that shoulder into the chin, into the chest there of Zhang Jinan. That's able to keep her pressed up against the cage like that. Zhang Jinan's now got the underhook. Might be able to circle out, and she does. Angela goes for the body lock, changes levels. Let's see if she can get the takedown again. She's utilizing, she's changing up her game as far as the takedowns are concerned. Look at that beautiful hip toss there. She grabbed the body lock. She was able to turn the corner and put Zhang Jinan on her back. This is where Angela Lee is most dangerous.
Open guard here from Zhang Jinan on her back. Let's see what Angela can do. So many submission variations that Angela is capable of. She can tie you up like a pretzel, like a ball of twine, and tap you out from anywhere. But what's Zhong Jin Nam been working on? She throws the legs up a little higher, Dragon.
She went for the rubber guard there. Let's see what she can do. She's trying to control the arms here of Angela Lee. She's got that guard nice and high, but maybe trying to attack an arm. Punching up the face there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee takes that leg for a ride, puts her on her back.
Up and down, star control for Angela Lee. Cuts the hip in, does the animate champion of the world. North-south position now.
Looking for a Kimura. Might possibly go for an armbar here.
Is Angela going to take that arm home with her? Zhong Jin Nam back to her feet and momentarily out of trouble. A back-and-forth contest, a seesawing battle for the strawweight crowd. Hear the pin drop silence in the Rio Goku Koku Giga, the most educated martial arts fans in the world here in Japan. I've been coming here for 18 years now, and they're always the same, Mitch. There are no smarter, no more appreciative fans in the martial arts world than the Japanese.
And there's a lot of technique for them to appreciate in this match here. Jinna's got to keep that space. She has to keep that separation. Keep it in the middle of the cage. Allow her to do work with those hands. Angelique's controlling a lot of the exchanges inside the clinch.
Zhong Jin Nam shakes out the hands, researches the champion, fires out a front kick, nicely placed to the midsection. Angela edging forward. Zhong Jin Nam beats her with a punch, two-punch combination. Overhand right from Zhong Jin Nam. Past the halfway point of this entire match. Left hook, right hand, the old 3-2 there from Zhong Jin Nam. Mitch, who would you have ahead at the moment?
Nice spinning back kick there from Zhong Jin Nam. At this point, I would have to say Angelique's ahead just because she's controlling a lot of the exchanges on the ground and up against the clinch. But Zhong Jin Nam is starting to turn it up right now. She's landed about 12 to 13 different shots here. Landed that spinning back kick.
Oh, left hook there from Zhong Jin Nam. And Angela does a quick count of her teeth.
Angela's eating a few punches, but she's still remaining composed. Standing there in front. Not really shooting for takedowns either.
Loading up on these rides and left hooks is Zhong Jin Nam. More hooks than a tackle box on the champion. And again, smack bang between the eyes. Overhand right from Zhong Jin Nam. Goes for the headache maker. Looks for a side kick. Angela backed off again with the right hand from Zhong Jin Nam. This is a great portion of the contest for the champion.
This has been the most successful portion of the time for Zhong Jin Nam. Angela Lee was starting to get touched up there in that middle part of that round. You could see she was taking a lot of shots, but she's remaining composed and she's still pushing forward. I see Angela Lee change up the game here, start throwing leg kicks. Go for a takedown. She hasn't taken one shot yet. Her only takedown attempts have been in the clinch up against the cage.
Zhong Jin Nam, chin tucked, looking through her brow. The champion's been on the money so far in this round with her striking. Here she comes again. The chin looks back on Angela Lee. There's an overhand right. There's a body shot. Lee's going to get off the cage here. And they clinch up. She locks down the arms of the champion. And here come the knees from Zhong Jin Nam. What a round from the Chinese world champion, Zhong Jin Nam. Angela threads a couple of knees to the right ribs. We do score on an overall contest, not round by round, but this has been a phenomenal round.
We have to wonder, is the second half of this contest gonna go the way of the Chinese punching panda? You can see her starting to overwhelm Angela Lee, landing big shots, flurrying on her. Angela Lee's getting caught up in the commotion, the chaos created by the champ.
What I like there, we saw it on the replay, Mitch. Angela took two, I think it may have been three, solid right hands. She had the composure, though, to do a little pirouette, a little quarter turn, and then strike back with two punches of her own.
She's a high-level martial artist.
That answers a lot of questions people had about what sort of punch Angela Lee could take from a heavier opponent from the punching guard of Zhong Jin Nam. It answered a lot of questions right there.
Well, we saw the punch coming from Mei Yamaguchi, the big right hand that dropped Angela Lee. Angela Lee was still able to come back. Ooh, she just caught a left hook there by Zhong Jin Nam.
Oh, the right hand from Angela tagged her on the chin. That was nicely done.
I like the change-up here of game plan. Angela Lee going after the trip, getting Angela
Xiong Xingnan to the ground. You see the change of tact here from Angela Lee. They talked to her in the corner. They said, take it down. Let's not let her strike against you. Let's get it to ground. That's your territory. That's Leeville. That's Leeville.
Right as Xiong Xingnan was starting to see a little bit of momentum, Angela Lee was able to put a stop to it and move on. Look, now she's inside. Now she's in half guard. Let's see what she can do here. Xiong Xingnan's got to keep her nice and tight. She's got possibly the overhook on the opposite side. You can see that far arm was over the head of Angela Lee. She's got to try to get it under. I think now she's just trying to stall and wait possibly for a stand-up. Angela Lee's not going to allow the position to go inactive for very long. She's going to start doing work.
Angela Lee came in many people's eyes as the favorite for this one. Xiong Xingnan, it looks like the game plan all along is to draw Angela into deep water. Close guard now from the strawweight champion, Xiong Xingnan. Angela trying to posture up, trying to break it open, work some ground and pound back. Hammer fist strike there from the atomweight world champion.
Good job from Xiong Xingnan to get back into guard. Feet on the hips.
Up kick there from Xiong Xingnan. And another one. Angela, side control, nicely done. Let's see where she goes from here, Mitch.
You can see Xiong Xingnan's trying to keep that head nice and close to her body to control the posture. She's trying to walk up the cage now. Create a scramble here. She's got to keep moving. She can't allow Angela Lee to start setting up these submissions.
Angela did not expect to be here. She thought she would have Xiong Xingnan out in the first round. And here we are in the penultimate, the fourth of five. 3 minutes remaining. And now in what they do call the deep water. Side control still for Angela Lee. What are the options here for Lee? What can Xiong Xingnan do, Mitch?
Right now she's got that head in control with her left arm. As she's going knee on belly, she might try to slide over into mount. Oh, Xiong Xingnan gives up her back. Xiong Xingnan might be able to escape out the back door, but she's got to be careful she doesn't give up her arm. Angelina's got a tight squeeze here. Might be an inverse triangle.
It looks like a demented game of Twister here between Xiong Xingnan and Angela Lee. Angela always hunting for a way to finish when it's on the ground, when it's on the feet. And you know the punching panda wants to get back to striking range.
Look at the way Angela Lee has that leg locked up. She's got that nice and tight. She's hunting after the arm right now. She does have the triangle possibly in. You can see how the triangle is locked up with her left leg underneath the knee of her right leg, and that's nice and tight, so she's gonna try to extend the arm here. She's gonna try to create a little bit of space and get...
Oh, is she gonna do it? Is she gonna tap out Xiong Xingnan? Not yet. Referee Kim Chen right on top of it. Angela's gonna try and soften up the champion a little more. Still 1 minute 35 remains in this fourth round. Angela wants the arm bar. She wants to take the arm home. Could the title be slipping away from Xiong Xingnan? Is Unstoppable going to make history? Is she?
Can she? It's not supposed to bend that
way. Can she make history, Angela Lee? She's going for it.
Look how tight that is. Look how tight the triangle is. She can't go anywhere. Watch the thumb.
She's going for it. Will she become a two-division champion?
She's still got a minute to work here. Xiong Xingnan's got to move. She's got to scramble.
Angela wants to take the arm home. Xiong Xingnan surviving. But with what punishment? With what damage? Angela softens her up a little more. Can she sense a victory soon? Can she smell a sub coming?
This is a long time for Xiong Xingnan to be trapped in this triangle. She's got to move. She can't go anywhere, though. She's just taking the beating.
Oh, here he goes again. That looks bad. That looks dangerous.
Xiong Xingnan won't give up.
This is crazy. Xiong Xingnan will not tap out. A belly down armbar from Angela Lee. And Xiong Xingnan, look at her face. Look at her grimacing. But she gives a thumbs up to referee Kim Chen.
There's a bit of space there in the triangle. You can see she doesn't have quite have that choking because look at the legs. Her foot is down near the calf, so she can't quite get that nice and tight. The armbar is there, though. Xiong Xingnan, there's no quitting her. She's okay.
Her face is turning purple. But the bell's almost here. A few more seconds, and the champion survived. The champion survived. We're going in to the fifth and final round.
That's hard. heart, her family keeps her in the match. She won't quit. There's no quit. Fifth round at this point. That's a near finish. Look at this. Parries the hand down, gets the hands deflected away, and comes right through the middle with a face rattling right hand. Beautiful. Then she slips underneath. The counter shot gets into the clinch, and that led to the triangle we just saw. That was a long time to be trapped inside that reverse triangle.
Folks, come and join us. Come and see a ONE Championship event live. All expenses paid. It's on us. To find out how, go to onefc.com/win. onefc.com/win. We'll bring you to ONE Championship. All expenses paid. We are seeing a gripping match for the strawweight world title. The survival of Xiong Jinnan, the champion, in front of a sellout crowd inside the Rio Gokugoku Gigan in Tokyo, Japan. The ONE Championship, a new era. 5 minutes remains for either Xiong Jinnan to retain or for Angela Lee to become an historic two-division world champion. Early trade of leather here. Xiong Jinnan showing damage around the right eye.
Angela Lee took two shots, shook her head, said, "You got nothing on me." Xiong Jinnan's gonna need a big round if she's gonna wanna take this. Well, she has to go for the finish. Nice body kick. Angela Lee scrimmaged just a bit on it.
Side kick there from Xiong Jinnan. Oh, big overhand right, the knees almost went. Angela Lee's knees almost went. There was the power of the champion. She goes to the body.
Looks exhausted at this point. There's not a lot coming back from the atomweight champ.
And this is what Xiong Jinnan wanted. This was the game plan all along. Draw her into deep water and punish her in the fifth round. Let's see what Xiong Jinnan to do now.
I think Angela Lee might have blew her gas tank out when she went for that triangle armbar finish. She is, her mouth is wide open. She's taking big shots.
This is Xiong Jinnan's time. When she's gonna go for it, she's gonna pull out all the stuff, throw caution to the wind. Angela Lee is blowing heavy. We've never seen Angela like this before. And here comes Xiong Jinnan with the overhand right. Another side kick. Straight into the guts of the atomweight champion. And a high hand. Angela's hurt. The body shot hurt her. The punching panda. Angela's in trouble. Angela's in trouble. It's over. The plan, take her into deep water. It worked. It's genius. It's brilliant. It's Xiong Jinnan. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilton with you. Xiong Jinnan, 6 first round finishes, 10 knockouts in 14 wins. Angela Lee, 6 subs in 9 wins. Both ladies with a 78% finishing rate. Overhand right early there from Xiong Jinnan. Just gives Angela a taste of the power of that right hand.
Wow, Angela's not backing down at all. Xiong Jinnan is stepping forward right into the pocket and starting throwing those hands. Angela's not backing down, exchanging with her.
Last time they met on March 31st, right here. Angela hurt Xiong Jinnan, and we were all amazed how Xiong managed to survive it. She then went into the fifth round and knocked Angela out.
Angela's got to be careful inside that pocket. Xiong Jinnan has touched you twice with that left hook. There's that hammer of a right hand coming from Xiong Jinnan.
Angela will want to take Xiong Jinnan down. It's where Angela is a specialist. 6 submissions, all have been different. Anaconda, twister, rear naked choke, neck crank, and armbar. So many options available in the submission game for Angela Lee. Hasn't had a sub win since tapping out Estela Nunes back in May 2017 with an anaconda choke in the second round. Good left hook there.
And that left hand, Michael, it's touching her over and over again. Those unorthodox right hands as well. She like comes in with an overhand hammer fist and she smacks Angela on the side of her head. Angela gets in deep, beautiful. Digging the underhooks from Xiong Jinnan as Angela presses her up against the circle wall.
Xiong Jinnan, member of the national boxing team, former powerlifter as well, tremendously strong individual, the strawweight champion.
Xiong Jinnan's got underhooks on both sides. That's gonna give her a little bit better control, and she might be able to spin Angela off the side of the cage just like that. Oh, good pressure from Angela, though. As Angela tries to swim in, pummels underneath. Xiong Jinnan's really strong inside that clinch.
Only the one knockout win for Angela stopped Jenny Wang with punches in the third round back in March 2017 in Bangkok. Left hook to right hand, the old 3-2 there from Zhong Jinan. Then they clash leg kicks. But already, Angela tasting the leather from Zhong. Skips forward, Angela doesn't commit off that lead leg. Zhong Jinan, the more flat-footed of the two, likes to plant herself and throw those powerful salvos off both hands. Evades the high kick, circles off clockwise. Angela skips back to center circle. Zhong goes counterclockwise now.
Not seeing a lot of the body shots yet from Zhong Jinan. Those body shots were wonderful. Actually helped her retain the strawweight title the last time we were here in Tokyo. Let's see if she starts to slowly work those back into her arsenal.
Last time, the plan of Zhong Jinan was to take Angela into deep water and then hurt the body. It worked out perfectly. It's exactly what happened on that occasion. Is it the same plan here tonight? How does Zhong break her own cardio? Coming down from strawweight to atomweight. Two-punch combination again. And a left hook from Zhong Jinan. Angela on the front foot, got to be careful. Chin a little high. They clinch up in tango, back against the circle fence.
See what Angelique can do inside here on the clinch, but again, Zhong Jinan's doing a good job of getting those underhooks, controlling that position. Those underhooks usually allow you to get a lot of control. Sometimes with the overhooks, enables you to, you know, do some hip throws. And she's kind of angling her body out there, framing off, creating a knee shield there to keep Zhong Jinan a little bit away from her. When she uses that overhook to spin her around.
Zhong Jinan has been floating on a cloud of confidence all week. I saw her at about 7:30 this morning in the hotel lobby, skipping down the lobby with a smile. She has been in high spirits, and I tell you what, I believe there's a big egg on the forehead here of Zhong Jinan that's opened up. The target for Angela to go after. 45 seconds to go, first round of five for the Women's Atomweight World Championship. If you're watching live in over 140 countries, big hello to all of our viewers for the first time live on TNT across the USA. Hope you're enjoying One Century. Left hook, right hand to the body there from Zhong Jinan. Smashing right hand. Had some fury behind it there. Angela with an uppercut. Zhong breaks off with a hook. Overhand right, the headache maker.
Right hand landed from Zhong Jinan again. Angelique's got to start moving. Her head's got to start a little bit more with the head movement. Get that head off the center line. Not allowing a stationary target for Zhong Jinan.
Duck under the hooking punch there from Angela Lee. Clinches up Zhong right at the end of the round. We're going into the second stanza. Both athletes go back to their respective corners. Big swinging leg kick below the lead knee there from Zhong Jinan. Angela counter left hook, and there's the counter hook from Zhong.
Beautiful leg kick to a three-punch combination from Zhong Jinan. Again, touching her over and over with that left hook. You said it, Michael, that her chin was a little bit up in the air. Angelique's got to make sure that chin is nice and tucked to her chest, because if that left hook keeps landing, it's going to set up that big right hand. That right hand is starting to land, but you can see Zhong Jinan's wearing the welts pretty well there. That damage is starting to build up on Zhong Jinan's face. So Angelique is touching Zhong Jinan a lot of these exchanges.
Working the end swell under the left eye there of Zhong Jinan, the team from Bali MMA. Team Lee, Father Ken, Brother Christian in the corner of Angela Lee.
Stay in your corner. Stay.
Circle door closes. We are ready for the second round of the One Women's Atomweight World Championship main event of One Century, set for five. Talk. Zhong Jinan with a hematoma on the hairline and also a mouse under the left eye. But there was some very good striking from Zhong Jinan in the first. Angela will want to get Zhong down. So many submission options available to Angela Lee, who has been unblemished at atomweight as the long time and defending champion. Zhong Jinan, chin tucked, looking through her brow. The former boxing champion spinning heel kick. Looks for the midsection, tries to fold Angela in half like origami. Body shot from Zhong. Did the damage on Angela back in March here at the Ryogoku Kokugikan. Fakes there from Zhong Jinan. two athletes, Mitch, who know each other intricately. Does it take something new and unexpected to turn the tide in this way?
I think it does from Angelo's point of view. You can see the confidence that's just been oozing out of Zhang Jing not all week in the entire build-up to this matchup here. Angelique's gonna have to change things up, and that's what I like. I like how she's pressuring Zhang Jingna against the circle wall, shooting for the takedowns. But Zhang Jingna has gotten so good at takedown defense. I'm sure her and her team over at Bali MMA have been drilling the takedown defense constantly because they believe that her keeping this on the feet is gonna be her ticket to becoming a two-division champion.
On One Fantasy, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, download it now on the One Super app. It was Angela Lee getting the shot from fans, some 62% of fans worldwide, predicting Angela Lee to retain the atomweight strap tonight. Chance for the knees here, knee guard put on though by Angela to block the right leg of Zhang Jingnan. Angela overhooking that left arm of the Chinese athlete.
Nice body lock takedown there from Angela Lee. She almost got it secured, but Zhang Jingna was able to pop right back up. We saw a lot of those body lock takedowns earlier in the night with Christian Lee, and Angela Lee's trying to do the same thing to Zhang Jingna, but Zhang Jingna able to pop right back up, keep this thing where she wants, and that's in that center of the circle.
A little palm heel break off there from Zhang. 2:40 remains, second round of five, a women's atomweight world title. Hook there from Zhang Jingna. How far she's tucking her chin. Left hook again from Zhang Jingnan.
I like how she's going to the body with that straight right hand and coming up top with that left hook.
Angela tried to pull the head down for the meet and greet. Wasn't there though. Zhang fakes with the lead hand. Angela shot down. Couldn't get it though. Couldn't wrap up the legs of the strawweight champion. Trying to keep Zhang on the outside here.
You would think the longer this match goes, the more it's going to favor the athlete who's been competing at this weight for a long time. But Zhang Jingnan's conditioning is second to none, and she hasn't slowed a bit yet.
But also, let's not forget, Match, that Angela's last two contests have been at strawweight, so she's also had to come down to atomweight for this one to defend her atomweight strap.
True. Nice leg kick, nice right hand, though, as Zhang Jingna answers the leg kick. You can see how tight her chin is, how low her head is.
We talk about the ground game of Angela Lee, how superb she is with the submissions, but do not underestimate the striking prowess of Angela Lee. Zhang knows that. She knows that Angela can loop in, also can with straight punches down the tube that could catch the jaw if she's not careful. Now we're on the ground.
Nice little single leg takedown there from Angela Lee. She was able to control the single leg, back her up, spin the corner, turn around, jump, dump Zhang Jingna on her butt.
All tied up here like a pretzel, Mitch. What are you looking at here?
I'm looking at Angela Lee taking that right leg, and she's going to try to circle to the right, maybe. If Zhang Jingna, if she can get past that left leg of Zhang Jingna, she might be able to circle around that right leg elevated like that.
Mitch, you've rolled with the team at Evolve MMA out of Singapore. What are the real strengths of Angela on the ground? What does Zhang really need to be careful of here?
It's her pressure. You can see how she applies that pressure. Once she gets you on the ground, the way she utilizes her shoulder pressure and her head movement is really exceptional, but also her transitions. She's consistently moving and attacking submissions. She doesn't give you a chance to rest.
Working off her back here, Zhang Jingna. Under 30 seconds remain, second round of five. It's Angela Lee defending the women's atomweight world title against the strawweight world champion, looking to make history. It was an unsuccessful bid for Angela last time here on March 31st to become a two-division world champion. Can Zhang Jingna do it tonight? Knees to the head there from Angela Lee. Ups the aggressive meter right at the end of the round here, Angela Lee. That's more like it from the champ, the unstoppable. Well, Angela Lee bringing down the knees on the ground at the end of the last round there, Dragon. Some confident signs from the champ.
Beautiful job from Angela Lee right there. She fakes the leg kicks, comes up top with the left hook, goes down low with the leg kick, but Zhang Jingna was able to answer. Now, this is where we're starting to see Angela Lee in her element. She was able to get Zhang Jingna down, work her way into the pass, drop a little bit of knees to the head, and then end that position, end that round in a very dominant position.
Christian Lee victorious earlier on tonight in the lightweight World Grand Prix over Dagi in the corner of his older sister here, Angela Lee, brother-sister world champions. And Team Bali MMA going to work the hematoma on the forehead, the mouse under the left eye of Zhong Jinan as we are ready for another round of this world title action. Third round of five. The one women's atomweight world championship defending champion Angel Lee upping the aggression. At the end of the previous round, Zhong Jinan damage on the face, chin tucked to chest. Angela comes out jabbing. Zhong Jinan with the left hook. It's been a treat for her so far. It's been her prime weapon in the striking. Angela looks for a low single. Do you sense any hesitation here from Zhong Jinan, Mitch?
Bit. You know, you gotta wonder, how has this weight cut affected her? She's been dominant for such a long period of time at strawweight, but now she's coming down. Her first match is a five-rounder against the champion in a weight class that she hasn't been to yet. So it's very interesting to see how this is gonna affect her.
Mitch, given the confidence we've seen from Zhong Jinan all week and you know the way she presented herself at the press conference a couple of days ago, do you feel that she thought she would put Angela out a lot earlier, that she wouldn't be here in the third round?
You know, I was talking to her corner just a few hours ago, and they were very confident they were going to be able to get her out in the early rounds. But Angela Lee, there's no quit in this young lady. She is definitely in here, and she has something to prove, not only to the entire world and the fans of mixed martial arts, but also to herself, that two-match skid that she's been on is not something that's going to affect her. And she believes that champion spirit that lives inside her is going to be what's going to take her to defend her athlete.
Let's remind you, though, those back-to-back defeats on Angela Strickland both came at strawweight here at atomweight, where she is the champion. She has been unstoppable.
Good job by Zhong Jinan to get underneath and swim that underhook in as Angela presses her up against. But that underhook was powerfully able as Angela was able to throw hip throw into a headlock position now in that takedown. Let's see if she starts to shove that arm in between her leg and possibly look for an arm lock.
Last time out on March 31st, it was at this point in the contest, around the third round, definitely into the fourth round, that Angela really did pick up steam on the ground and trouble Zhong Jinan with the submission attempts. The face wide open here on Zhong Jinan, open for punishment off that left hand of Angela Lee.
Just, you asked me what makes Angela Lee different on the ground, not just basically her innovative style. She's constantly looking for unorthodox submissions. She spent a lot of time training and shooting at everything. Shove that arm in between her legs and look for a possible arm lock.
Zhong cannot take a lot more punishment to that left eye. It is starting to close up there for the strawweight world champion. It's a target for Angela to go after. Angela's going to take it back to Zhong Jinan. She's going to try and hook that arm. The left arm of Zhong Jinan.
Zhong Jinan's got to be very careful here. Angela's sneaking around her back. Now, this is where Angela is very dangerous. She's got twister finishes. She's got a lot of choke finishes. So Zhong Jinan's got to be very patient here and keep her wits about her. Listen to her corner.
Six submissions in 9 wins for Angela Lee. An anaconda, a twister, a rear naked choke, a neck crank, and an armbar. She can do it all. A whole buffet of submissions available for Angela Lee. Can she slap that on Zhong Jinan here? Jinan has been in this predicament before, surviving the onslaught on the ground of Angela Lee.
Look at the way Angela Lee's using her legs to control the legs of Zhong Jinan. A lot of people only just stick their hooks in and just kind of hold that position. Zhong Jinan is constantly moving, and Angela Lee is moving with her to prevent Zhong Jinan from spinning and going chest to chest. Beautiful technical details coming from Angela Lee right now.
If you're in the corner of Zhong Jinan, Dragon, if you're part of Bali MMA, what are you screaming to the strawweight world champion?
The first thing she has to do is protect her neck. The first thing she has to do, she has to watch out because Angelique's going to try to soften her up. She's going to try to throw those punches, get Zhong Jinan thinking about the punches, and then she's going to slowly try to slide one of those arms into the neck. But what she has to do, she's got to deal with the legs. She's got to try to scoop those and go chest to chest. It's a bad spot for the strawweight queen right now.
And still a lot of time remaining in this third round. 45 seconds for Zhong Jinan to defend the attempted choke here from Angela Lee. Angela taking her time. Zhong, it's all defense now. It's all survival for the strawweight world champion.
This is an important transition right here. Zhang Jingna could spin.
Angelina
might let go of that body triangle and end up in mount.
23 seconds on the clock.
It's more of a face crank at this point.
Angelina squeezing, and Zhang Jingna defends again. 10 seconds, like it sounds. What survival from Zhang Jingna? What a round from Angela Lee! Look at her go! Raising the aggressive meter once more, Angela Lee!
This is what happened last time, Michael. If you remember the last time we were in Tokyo in the fourth round, Zhang Jingna was able to survive a deep armbar and triangle attempt from Angela Lee, and that just boosted her confidence, almost made Zhang Jingna angry in the fifth and final. But now as we enter the championship rounds, what's that gonna play in the mind of Zhang Jingna? Look at that deep armbar. Again, Zhang Jingna survives another deep submission. How does she bounce back as we hit the championship rounds? Beautiful headlock control there.
Mitch, whose gas tank is affected more by that final period on the ground?
See, I would have thought that Zhang Jingna's gas tank would have been affected the most because she was constantly worried about the attacks and defense. But given what happened last time, I can't say that now. You know Zhang Jingna's got a giant gas tank.
We are ready for the penultimate round of action. Penultimate round, 4 of 5 inside the Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo for one century. Our main event for the women's atomweight world title. Zhang Jingna, the strawweight champion, trying to make history and become a two-division world champ. Angela Lee, right of screen defending. Zhang Jingna, can she get off the heavy artillery now? Got to land the hands, got to land the legs, got to slow Angela down. Not let Angela take her down and get on top or get her back.
See, Zhang Jingna starting to blink heavily. She's trying to squint her eyes. Hear that vision just a little bit. Nice little exchanges there. Angelique still looks fresh, though.
Left hook from Zhang Jingna. Chin tucked once more, looking through the brow. Skips away there as Angela came forward with the cross. Probing jab from Angela. What will she use to lead into an attempted takedown? Jab two, kangaroo there from Zhang Jingna.
Straight right hand landed by Zhang Jingna. She still comes in with the back of the bottom of her hand. It's a very awkward punch, similar to Ung Lan Song's punch.
The thing I'd like to see here, though, from Zhang Jingna, Mitch, when she throws the 1-2, follow through. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's keep going with the combination works and really try and apply that pressure to Angela Lee and see if Angela cracks.
She's landing with a lot of these shots. But she kind of eases off and she backs away after she lands them.
Oh,
it was a close kick to a grounded opponent, possibly, but it looked like she actually kicked the chest of Angela Lee as Angela Lee was getting up. It was a beautiful technical decision.
That punch
just landed by Zhang Jingna.
Connecting for Zhang Jingna.
Maybe she doesn't need to follow up. Maybe she can finish her with just that beautiful 1-2 she keeps landing.
Really? Two opponents who know each other so well, and the similarities from March 31st, when we were right here, Mitch, in the Ryogoku Kokugikan, it's eerie. It's like we are seeing a repeat of the last time. They clinch up against the circle. Angela backs her against the fence, throws a knee to Angela Lee. What can Zhang Jingna do off the wire here?
She's got that underhook on that right side, so that's gonna give her a little bit of better opportunity to circle out to her left.
Gut munching knee from Angela. Zhang Jingna wants to create some room to work her strikes. Turns Angela against the wire now. Angela just glances towards her corner. Her father Ken Lee with the instructions there. Brother world champion Christian Lee. Also world Grand Prix champion now, Christian Lee.
Good job by Zhang Jingna to press Angela Lee up against the cage and see if she tries to separate her if she's gonna drop down into a takedown.
Knee there from Zhang Jingna, knee guard put on from Angela. 2:10 remaining, 4th round of 5. Now once again, folks, these contests are scored as overall bouts, not round by round, by our 3 judges here circle side. Jack two from Angela, didn't quite have the mustard behind it. Zhang turns to a and flies across down the center corridor.
She's connected on those minor breaks, those slight pauses inside the exchanges. Zhang Jingna is able to land.
At this stage, Mitch, 4th of 5, 1:40 to go. I think Angela looks a lot fresher now than she did back in the 4th round on March 31st.
Yeah, definitely. She looks a lot better condition in this 4th round than she was the last time these two went at it. But I can't deny the fact that Angela Lee has got to be in better condition for this one. She's, you know, after the loss to Michelle Nicolini, she went right back into the lab, the programs, and got right back into it. Now she's got to be in good shape.
Zhang Jingnan on the outside, circling clockwise, throws the left hook. Body shot didn't connect there for the strawweight world champion. Carving a large arc in the circle here, Zhang Jingnan. Two punch combination, outside leg kick from Angela. Angela straight back in on her now, sticks a jab, both women trade. It was Zhang who drew the short straw. Good short right hand from Angela. Nice weave under the left hook there from Zhang Jingna.
Good head movement from Zhang Jingna. Her head's never in the same place. She's constantly bobbing and weaving back and forth, left and right. Not giving Angela a stationary target, but that's how I like Angela going to the body kicks. So that way she can keep that pressure on Zhang Jingna.
Zhang Jingna. Lots of footwork here from the Chinese athlete. Angela comes forward, Zhang too evasive though. Angela throws her legs up and says, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna run from me, Zhang Jingna? Angela wants Zhang in a phone booth. Zhang comes forward, now left hook from the strawweight champion. Angela's not backing off. Angela's coming forward. Angela's talking to her. Says, let's go into the fifth and final. Sending a message to Zhang.
And she's actually the one hunting down. She's the one cutting the angles, making sure that Zhang Jingna is in front of her so she can let go of the strikes. But Zhang Jingna is landing. She is, you know, scoring a lot of these shots just like that, right there. Beautifully done. Off balances Angela Lee. Backs her up, puts her down. She's waiting. She's faking. Look at this. Beautifully timed. Left hand form, just a stumble from Angela Lee rather than that big right hand landing. But then beautifully done. As Angela Lee was getting up, lands that kick right to the chest of Angela Lee. Great job by Zhang Jingna to have her wits about her and not go for the head kick.
The cold dress again being worked over the hematoma on the forehead of Zhang Jingna. Lots of instructions from Ken and Christian Lee in the corner of Angela. Inside the Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo for the 5th and final round. What a cracker. What a corker it's been so far. Fifth and final round. The second chapter in this epic rivalry between Zhang Jingna and Angela Lee. Left hook early from Zhang goes to the body. Lee eats a left. Overhand right from Zhang. Zhang Jingna fakes the front kick off the back leg, circles off to her left. Angela looking to control center circle, maybe press Zhang back. Leg kick there from Angela. Trying for a hammer fist strike and a short left hook. Angela presses her against the fence.
And this is where Angela's very dangerous now. She's got that body lock and she's also got that underhook on that side. She's gonna try to press in. She's probably looking for a body lock takedown. She's looking to clasp her hands and spin Zhang Jingna back down to her backside.
Who will emerge? The women's atomweight world champion in 4:10 time. Will Zhang Jingna make history as a two-division world champion? Will Angela Lee defend in a division where she has been unstoppable?
Good defense from Zhang Jingna to work her way back away from the circle wall. She's trying to swim and get that underhook on the left side. That she does. Now she gets the body lock. Let's see if she can change the trajectory of this clinch and spin Angela Lee against the circle wall. No, she chooses to separate.
Oh! Zhang Jingna smiles and nods at Angela. You feel something big is coming from Zhang Jingna's hands very soon.
Man, something big's growing on the side of Zhang Jingna's head, though.
It's got its own zip code. Body shot there from Zhang Jingna. Angela, patient though, picking her openings, trying to thread the jab here, Angela Lee. Left hook, right hand. Need a bit more start behind it there. He's had more hooks than a Pirates convention.
Beautiful takedown defense. Let's see if Angela Lee can finish or Zhang Jingna.
she has that body lock on. It's a bad spot for Zhong Jinna. Angelique's got the back now. Let's see if she can dig in that second hook.
Halfway through the fifth and final round, Angela Lee giving it her all. And once again, Zhong Jinna needs to defend against a lady with a 78% finishing rate with 6 submissions in 9 wins.
You can see Angelique's trying to cradle that leg, trying to separate, possibly go for a banana split. This is where Angelique is so dangerous. She's got so many different submission opportunities. One of the owners of the only twister ever seen in one championship. See what she decides to do here. She tried to pull up that arm so she can slide that hook in. Jones is not doing a good job of defending that hook. Angelique might not even need the second hook to secure a submission lock here.
They will be going.
I think she's gonna try to take that arm, lace it around her head, look for a twister.
They'll be going absolutely crazy in Hawaii at the moment on TNT for Angela Lee. Taking her time, nice strike, and that was a wicked one above the left ear of Zhong Jinna. Again, Kinley calls for the elbow, and Angela throws it. Again, the corner calling for elbows and punches from Angela. Still has the back of the strawweight world champion, just the atomweight world champion. The rivalry between these two, like nothing else in one championship. Tremendous respect for each other, but also a tremendous desire to triumph.
What's the difference between the judges' scorecards right here, Michael?
Can Zhong find a way back to her feet? What's Angela looking for now, Dragon?
She's trying to separate. She's trying to take Zhong Jinna's left right arm, wrap it around her head, possibly for a twister. But Zhong Jinna's wise to it. She's not allowing it to happen. But that was enabling Angelique to get both hooks into the legs there of Zhong Jinna. Now she's starting to pound her out. She's got 34 seconds.
Zhong Jinna has never been beaten in the championship. Her mark, measuring her punches.
Oh, it's underneath.
Now for the choke.
That is.
Is this it?
18 seconds to go.
Is it over? She puts it out like a turning pancake.
Oh, it's underneath.
My word, it's crazy. Crazy scenes here in Tokyo. Emotional outpouring for Angela as her father Kinley and brother Christian Lee embrace her. Phenomenal scenes here. You could not have scripted that in a Hollywood movie. Sibling world champions, Christian Lee and Angela Lee. So many people doubted her. What a moment for a phenomenal, phenomenal young athlete. So many people doubted her, but not tonight. Tonight belongs to Angela Lee. And at a weight, she is still unstoppable.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 48 seconds in the fifth and final round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, and still one at a weight world champion, Angela.
And the rain of gold
Princess Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.